Hello friends, so in the last video we have learned about the isometric construction of the isometric projection of a hemisphere which is placed over a square block, right? This is also a similar question. In this question we are going to construct the isometric view of a hemisphere which is placed on the frustum of a cone, okay? So you can see the question right now. The question is, draw the isometric view of a hemisphere of diameter 30 mm which is placed over a frustum of a cone having top face diameter 25 mm, bottom face diameter 45 mm and having a height of 20 mm with the circular face of the hemisphere upwards. So this is the question. The first thing is we have to construct the orthographic projection of the hemisphere which is placed over the frustum of a cone, right? So in the top view you can see the 45 centimeter diameter, you can see the 30 centimeter diameter, and you can see the 25 centimeter means millimeter, 25 millimeter diameter, right? So you can see three circles. So this is the 45 mm diameter, this is the 30 mm diameter, and this is the 25 mm. So these two belongs to frustum of the cone and this belongs to the hemisphere. So in the front view, at a height of 20, this is 20, this is 20, you can see this circle. So this is the front view of the frustum of the cone. And on top of that, the hemisphere of a radius 30, diameter 30. So you can see the orthographic projection right now on your screen. Okay. So now we have to construct the isometric view of this hemisphere which is placed over the frustum of the cone. So the first thing is you can enclose this in a square, and we have to construct, see, listen, the isometric projection or isometric view of this hemisphere will consist of an ellipse here, an ellipse here, and an ellipse here, right? So here will be an ellipse, here will be an ellipse, and here will be an ellipse. So the easy method is, first we have to construct the box for that drawing that ellipse, right? So that we can draw an box corresponding to this layer, corresponds to this layer, and it corresponds to this layer. And once we complete that box, then we can go for that construction of ellipse, and after completing the ellipse we can connect so that we can obtain the isometric projection of this hemisphere placed on the frustum of this cone, right? So this problem can be solved from top to bottom. That will be easier for this particular question, which means we can construct the box for this top layer, then we can go for the bottom layer, and then we can go to the bottom layer, okay? So we know that this is a box containing diameter of 30, clear? So, or we can complete this question in the normal way, so that first we can construct the box for this one, then for this one, and then for this one. We can complete in this manner. So draw the horizontal line, draw the 30 degree line, draw the 30 degree line. Now we know that this is 45, so take 45 here, take 45 here, so now we have completed the bottommost layer of this problem, right? The next step is we can complete it this layer. There are a lot of methods, but the easier method is construct a box here. Construct your enclose this circle and enclose this circle in corresponding square. So we know that now we have to obtain the layer for this one, because this circle belongs to the topmost point of the frustum of the cone. Second layer is the first top face of the frustum of the cone. So now we have to obtain this layer. So enclose it in a rectangle. Now we have obtained four interior points using the method that we have described earlier. We can obtain the four points inside this initial layer as a point here, as a point here, and as a point here. So now we have obtained the four inside points belongs to these points. But we know that this layer is lying at a height of 20 mm, right? So from this point, draw a height of 20, draw a height of 20, draw a height of 20, and draw a height of 20, so that now we have obtained the layer for this one, or the top face of that cone, right? So that also we have obtained. Now we have to obtain this layer. How can we obtain? Using the same principle. That means locate these four points. Locate these four points inside this initial layer as points, that points be lying somewhere here. You can obtain these four points by the usual procedure. And once you obtain those points, where will be this layer is lying? That layer is lying at a height of 20 plus 15, that is 35 from the bottom layer, right? So from this point, at a height of 35, we can obtain the layer for the topmost circle, right? So we have obtained one layer here, another layer here, and another layer here. Now, how can we complete this? See, this is the layer here. This is the layer here. So using the Fossander method, we can complete a circle here. See, why I am drawing this circle first? Because if I can draw this from here, the visibility checking will be easy, so that only the portion visible can be drawn. Okay, so see, using the Fossander method, we can complete the ellipse here. Complete the ellipse here. Now it's the time for constructing an ellipse here. So, see, this is the ellipse, but there is a problem. See, if we complete this hemisphere right now, only the portion visible need to be drawn. So, once you complete the hemisphere here, see, like this, because now we can obtain the center here. Since we are constructing the isometric view, we can complete this hemisphere by drawing a radius of 15 into 1.22. So multiply 1.22 and 15 and draw an arc, so that arc will intersect somewhere here. Okay, so the hemisphere is completed. Now This is the four center method. For four center method, we have completed this. So now, using this four center method, this portion can be drawn. This portion is enough. This portion is enough. Using this center, this portion is enough because the remaining portion will be invisible. So if we are drawing this question from top in this direction, we can draw only the portion which is visible. Okay. So this is completed. Now this is another bottommost layer, keeping this as center, using the four center method. See, this is the portion. Only this much is required because the remaining portion will be invisible. So now connect like this tangentially and connect like this tangentially, so that see. So here you can see the frustum of the cone, and on the frustum of the cone there is a hemisphere. So I hope all of you have understood this question. Thank you.